Hello guys, welcome back to the channel again. This is going to be part 5 of the Arctic series, and will actually be a double feature or a multi-level mission flight. So we're going to be simulating a rescue of a stranded aircraft with casualties, which is the DHC-6. And we're going to be effecting the rescue with the H-3. This is actually the Mark 4, but same aircraft, slightly different configuration. So we're actually going to be flying out to the location of the stranded aircraft and simulating dropping off fuel supplies and the things they need for the rescue, as well as pick up the casualties and bring them back to this location. And once we complete that part of the mission, then we'll actually switch to the DHC-6 and actually fly it from the emergency location back to the main base here at ENSB. So we're going to do a slightly abbreviated start using the start cart and the battery together here, so we're going to get that going. Get back in the cabin here, release the rotor brake, put both engines back to normal out of the test mode, power on, both engines to start position. And spool up the engines to about 50%, and then we'll remove the start cart and continue on from there. I don't like these wipers, so I'm gonna actually cut those off. We can go ahead and close the hatch. Alright, I'm going to remove the start cart now, or the GPU if you will. I'm going to wait about 8 seconds, and then I'll actually throttle to full. I want to give the anti-ice time to all, make sure that's engaged, because sometimes it doesn't work. And we will be flying in icing conditions today. Full throttle. Let the governor settle down and we'll be on our way. We're actually going to be flying out and to the left up to a small inlet that has two summits on either side, and the summit that's near to us will be the one we're actually going to try to touch down on. To also simulate more of a true rescue scenario, we will be flying heavy both ways. So we're just shy of our max for this this environmental condition. And we will be slightly lighter on the way back since the casualties won't weigh nearly as much as fuel and the parts needed for the rescue. And as I've mentioned before, since I do this all in real time, you know, there will be things that I miss or maybe mistakes that I make, so if you notice any of that or you have a question, comment, anything like that, always feel free to put that in the comment section below the video. Foggy, but it is kind of high, so I don't think our visibility is going to be that affected, really, because we're not going to go anywhere near that the bottom of that ceiling. Which is at about 11,000 feet. Looks that way, maybe 10, 11. As I said, as we start to get closer up here on the left, you'll see a fairly large inlet. And There'll be a summit on either side of that, and we're going to be going to the one nearest to us. Which it's the largest, and the one that has the most level areas, so it would be the most likely place to have been, done a touchdown for emergency landing. Versus the lowest lying areas, but we're going to assume that they use a summit to make it a little more challenging. So you should be able to start to see the inlet up here on the left that I'm talking about. And we're going to slightly go about maybe an eighth of the way into that. Actually turn and come back before we land on the summit. That way we have the wind at our head. Plus there's also a slight grade as well on the slope. So we want to try to get a little more of an uphill orientation on that. That way, if the brakes slip, we can use the rotor to give us a little bit of a forward push. You could also do it in reverse, but the way the wheel's set up is on this particular helicopter, you have a lot more stability in the front end, so that's why we want to go in that direction if we can. So there's the inlet directly ahead of us, and we're going to be going to the summit that's directly on our left here at about 11 o'clock. Once we touch down, we're going to simulate a hot load, so we're not actually going to shut the helicopter completely down. We're just going to reduce the rotor speed to a high idle. Obviously, I can't have the DHC-6 loaded at the same time, so we'll just have to use our imagination and pretend it's here for now. Side hatch here. And we'll do about a 20 second count to simulate a very quick hot loading of the patients and offloading of the supplies. So we'll go with 30 for that. That's about 30 right there, so we're going to close this side hatch and get back in to get the engines back up to full tilt and head back on our way. I said we're still fairly heavy, but not We're not overweight, that's for sure. And if you're not comfortable with this model, or you're not used to that type of flying, you can definitely reduce the weight from practicing to make it a little easier for you. But don't go too light, or you may actually make it a little harder, or you'll run out of fuel, which you definitely don't want that. Unless you want to have a double rescue on your hands. So now we're just heading back to the LZ-1. And then we'll make the transition and the switch over to the second part of the mission, which will be with the DHC-6. So I'll actually pause the simulation while I make that switch. So on your end, it'll just be maybe a 1 second pause while I set all that up. And then when it returns, it'll be in the fixed wing ready to go. And also the weather. You can reduce the weather if you're not quite up to par just yet. You know, much better to reduce some of the settings and get a good practice in versus doing it, you know, to a level that's so difficult you can't even really learn anything. This is a pretty easy model to fly, really, once you learn the sort of old school controls. Actually want to go down in this little valley here to get rid of some of this altitude, and once we go around the corner we'll be at the airport. You can see these Doppler radar units up on top of the summit there. That's a good landmark to use if you want to know when you're near the airport. Because they're on the summit that's directly above it. And once we go around the corner, you can see the runway markers. As well as, I think there's actually a beacon in the water too, but I can't remember 100% sure. Now if you do want to simulate this directly, the wind is 8 knots sustain with about a 4.5 knot gust. Temperatures are a little over 35. And visibility is fairly good as long as you stay under, like I say, that 10,000 foot ceiling. And you can use the default settings, or I always like to use the sky colors to adjust them manually. Follow the exact same configuration of the flight path. You know, as long as you can get from point A to point B and back again in a safe manner, and then whatever's easiest for you, or whatever makes the most sense to you, that's going to be the best plan to use. So as long as you get there efficiently, safely, quickly, that's the first part of the flight. So like I said, there will be about a 1 second pause, and the next thing you should see is the second aircraft, the DHC-6, loaded and ready to try to get it started for the return to the airport from its emergency landing location. So give me just 1 second. Alright guys, welcome back. We're about to start part two of the flight. So as you can see, we have the DHC-6 ready to go here. Try to get the engine started. This model does have a winch on effect, so we will use the wipers for this one. Lower the flaps. I'm actually going to have to go about a 180 degree turn here though to get to the direction we want to be for the takeoff. Right there, I think. Oh, that was pretty easy, huh? Gonna back off on the flaps a bit. And as I mentioned earlier, we're gonna be headed back to ENSB. This is version 2 of this aircraft, so this is the XP-11 update, which if, like me, you already owned the original, you can check your invoice and get a 50% discount on this model. Which that will give you a cost of just under $15, which is really not that bad. And with it being an STMA model, it comes with the automatic updater, so you don't have to ever worry about downloading the updates yourself, which is a feature I wish more developers would use. Sort of see the runway coming up here on our right. Starting to drag. drag flaps back in again here, because we will be landing fairly heavy. On the payload, the fuel load's pretty light, but we're also simulating the fact that the majority of the passengers were not injured, so they're still on the DHC-6 here. And I'm not sure what the name of this, the flap style is, where you have the sort of an infinite number of settings instead of fixed position. So if someone knows the name of that, if there is a name, let me know in the description. So I'm going to be laying a little bit cross with that wind, which is a skill that I'm definitely not good at. So hopefully this won't end in disaster. Guys, it's going to be the end of this flight, so this is the Arctic Series Part 5, which is a double feature. I'll probably do single features with both the DHC-6 and the H-3 in the future, so they'll have their own independent flights, but I just thought it would be an interesting idea to try a combination for this one. So, as always, appreciate you guys watching. You can leave your questions or comments below. And I'll see you on the next flight, guys.